Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson, that is materials, metals and non-metals. Okay, in yesterday's introductory session I have let you know about what topics we are going to learn into the metals and the non-metals lesson. Okay, and as I said you, I am going to teach you everything in detail, so that this lesson is also going to be, today's session is also going to be very interesting. Okay, but various things which you might feel it is difficult, but these are not difficult. If you will ask me frequently and if you will watch my video frequently, you will get to know. Okay, so students, metals, I said you, actually elements are there. Okay, elements are arranged in the form of, means elements are bifurcated in the form of metals and the non-metals. Okay, yesterday I said you. So it is arranged based on its increasing atomic number. Okay, increasing atomic number, which is denoted by letter Z. Okay, that we will learn everything in detail in the further classes. That is no worries. But here, while teaching you metals, you must understand the concept of the metal. And for that sake, these are some primary things that you should know. So I am saying you. Okay, so metals are arranged, metals and non-metals both are arranged into the model periodic table according to its increasing atomic mass number. Okay, by increasing atomic mass number was the previous concept. Okay, mass number was the previous concept which was decided by the Mendeleev. Mendeleev was one chemist who said first we will arrange the elements based on the increasing atomic mass number. But later on it is discovered that it is not fruitful. We must arrange the elements based on the increasing atomic number. And because of that, various problems will get resolved. So that modern periodic table, various scientists sat together and decided the table would be arranged based on the increasing atomic number. Okay, so first thing you should know, that is atomic number means what, right? Atomic number means the either the number of protons or the number of electrons present into the atom, understood? And which is denoted by letter Z. Okay, you are knowing, student, ki for every metal or for every element, at the middle there is a nucleus, right? At the middle there is a nucleus which is very very hard in nature. Okay, this nucleus never takes part into the reactivity, understood? So nucleus contains what? Protons present into the nucleus, positive protons are present into the nucleus, and chargeless neutrons are present into the nucleus. See, students, this is what the nucleus, this is what nucleus, and the nucleus contains positive proton. Okay, protons would be present into the nucleus, which is the important part of the atom. Atom is made up of mainly three particles, and those three particles are what? Proton, neutron and electron. And here I am saying their location, where exactly they are located into the atom. So if suppose we will say that it is nucleus, which is the hard, actually all mass of the atom is accumulated into the nucleus, understood? So if you will talk about this nucleus, then this nucleus contains positive proton and chargeless neutrons are also present. Okay, chargeless neutrons are present, and beside it shells are there. What are there? Shells are there. Okay, shells, or we can say orbits are there. And in first orbit, the capacity to occupy the electrons are what? Two. In the first orbit always there are two electrons, not more than two electrons. Okay, in the second orbit or shell, there are 8 electrons. And in third, 18 electrons are present. In the third, how many? 18 are present. And in the fourth, there are 32 electrons are present. How many? 32 electrons are present. I hope you understand, this is the structure of atom, right? And this is the nucleus of an atom, and this nucleus is composed of what? Positive proton and chargeless neutron. Neutrons do not have any charge, right? And these are called as a what? Electrons. These are what? electrons. Electrons are always denoted by negative sign and protons are always denoted by positive sign, and there are neutrons which do not possess any charge. Okay student, and I just now I said you atomic number is denoted by letter Z, right? Then atomic number is denoted by letter Z. Then what is mean by atomic number? First you must understand what is mean by atomic number. The atomic number is either the number of proton or electron present into the atom. Do you understand what I said? Either the number of proton or the number of electron present into the atom. Why I use either? Because always number of proton and number of electron are always equal in number. Or we can say both are always equal in number. Means suppose this is the atom of the sodium, right? Sodium, if suppose this is the atom of the sodium which has atomic number, this is the sign of the atomic number, which has atomic number 11 suppose. It means that it has either 11 protons or either 11 electrons are present. I hope this concept is clear for you. Once again, I would like to repeat for all of you that atomic number is what? The either the number of proton or number of electron present into the atom is called its atomic number. Okay, and atomic number is denoted by letter Z. Okay, and here if I have taken the example of sodium, means sodium atom contains either number either the protons, it's an either the number of proton or it's a number of electron. Okay, so sodium has atomic number Z. Its electronic configuration. Okay, then the second concept is what? Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration means what, students? How this 11 protons or 11 electrons, which is said to be atomic number, is divided. Okay, how it is bifurcated, how it is sorted into the atom. So it is sorted in the form of in the first shell, there is a capacity to occupy always 2 electrons, not more than 2 electrons. So the capacity into the atom to occupy is always 2 electrons. So in the first shell there will be 2 electrons, right? So 2 get cancelled means how many are remaining now? 9 are remaining, right? Because 2 we have written in the first shell. Now in the second shell, 8 electrons, right? So 9 minus 8, now 1 is remaining into the outermost shell, right? So electronic configuration of the sodium will be 2, 8, 1. I hope, and it's not easy to understand immediately because you are quite small and you have never gone through this, but this is the concept of the atomic number. Once you would understand these concepts, then in future you would be easily understand the properties of the metal. And not only the physical properties, but also chemical properties would be really going to be very easy for all of you. Okay, so here again I would repeat, see, this is the structure of atom, right? In the nucleus is present here, which is the hardest part of the atom. All, we can say that all the mass of the atom is accumulated near to the nucleus or into the nucleus. And the wall of the nucleus is very, very strong. The wall of the nucleus is what? Very, very strong. And so that nothing, the electrons cannot enter inside or protons cannot come outside. This is the arrangement of the nucleus. Nucleus is the hardest part of the atom. All the mass of the atom is accumulated into the nucleus. Okay? Protons, this is the wall is like Ambuja cement, no more than that. It's so strong that protons cannot come out and electrons cannot enter inside. Understood? So nucleus contains positive protons, chargeless neutrons do not possess any charge. Please keep in mind, neutron do not possess any charge into the atom. So positive protons, charged neutrons are present into the nucleus, and there are orbits or shells which surrounds the nucleus. Those orbits or shells contains what? Electron. These orbits or shells contains what? Electrons, and which are revolving around the nucleus. But these are not revolving anyhow into the nucleus. Then there is a specific rule for them to revolve. Means into the first shell always there will be two electrons. Only two electrons is the capacity of the first shell. Not more than two electrons can occupy into the first shell. Okay students, into the second shell the capacity to occupy is what? 8 electrons. Not more than 8 electrons can occupy into the second shell. If you will talk about the third shell of the atom, then it has capacity to occupy 18 electrons. Not more than 18 electrons. Understood? With the 17 electrons, the what would happen? That is only the secret that I shall let you know very soon. Okay? Now, and into the fourth shell, there is a capacity to occupy what? 32 electrons. So, the electrons are arranged into the orbit like 2, 8, 18, 32. So, I hope at least this point is clear for you, that nucleus is made up of proton which contains positive charge. Chargeless neutrons are present, and around the proton there are some electrons which are revolving in a specific manner, not in a haphazard manner. They are moving around the nucleus into the specific manner. Means first shell contains 2, second shell contains 8, third shell contains 18, and fourth shell contains 32 electrons. In this manner it is revolving around the nucleus. Okay. And electrons are always denoted by negative sign. Okay. And atomic number. What is mean by atomic number? Atomic number is either the number of protons or electrons present into the atom. And always this number is equal. So only said na, either the number of protons or electrons. Means the number of protons will always equal to the number of electrons. Suppose I have taken here example of sodium. Sodium has atomic number what? 11. Means the number of protons are 11 and number of electrons are also 11 into the atom. Okay. So, number of protons are 11, number of electrons are 11, but they are not concerned at all. They are the part of the atom, but they cannot intermix or interact with each other. It is not possible, right? So, if you will talk about the electronic configuration, then the electronic configuration will be 2, 8, 1. Why first 2? Because the first shell has the capacity to occupy only 2 electrons, and second shell has capacity to occupy 8 electrons. And you may say, ki, why madam there are no 18 electrons? Because the atomic number is only 11. So from where we can bring the further electrons? It's not possible. So that only one electron is remaining into the outermost shell of the sodium atom. Understood? Means if this is now not sodium atom, I have given example. But if I would draw here the diagram of if the atomic structure of the sodium atom, then in the first shell there will be 2 electrons. Okay, I will draw for you so that it will be clear for you. Okay, suppose if I am talking about the sodium is the name, right? But it is denoted by Na. Why it is? Because it is its Latin name, that is the natrium, and it is denoted, it's symbolized by its Latin name, that is natrium. Okay, you may say, if it is sodium, then why you have not written SO? No, we don't write. Sodium is the name, common name for it, and it is the symbol. Very soon I shall let you know everything in detail. Okay, so it's a symbol of the sodium. This is mean by natrium. Okay, so if you will talk about sodium, how many protons are there? 11 positive protons are present into the nucleus, and chargeless neutrons are present. Okay, and in the first shell how many? 2 electrons are there. In a second shell how many? 8 electrons are there, and outermost shell it will have only one electron and its atomic number, which is always denoted by letter Z. And mass number, is different concept that we shall learn later. Atomic number, which is denoted by letter Z, is what? 11. It means that 11 positive protons equal to 11 negative electrons. Electrons are always denoted by the negative number. Understood, students? So this is the structure of the atom, or this is the structure of the element. Because I said you, element is bifurcated into three forms. What are those? Metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Metals are always called as a electropositive in nature. Why metals are called as electropositive in nature? That I shall reveal in front of you. Now, students, see, there is a outermost shell. So this is the outermost shell electron, right? Outermost shell means, this is outermost shell is also called as a valence shell. The shell which is at the last of the, means the outermost shell of any atom, is also called as a valence shell. It is called as what? Valence shell. Okay, means outermost shell. And in the outermost shell of an atom, how many electrons are present? Only one electron is present. Understood? And this one electron is very eager to stable, because everyone into the life wants stability. So this atom, sodium atom, also wants to be stable. But when it will be stable? Well, it will have 8 electrons in its outermost shell, that time it will be stable. See, for stability, one more very important thing is that for the stability of the atom, two things are needed. These two things are, by duplet rule it can be stable, or by octet rule it can be stable. Any atom can be stable either by duplet rule or octet rule. Now you may ask, what is mean by duplet rule? Duplet means double. If two electrons are present into the outermost shell, then also that atom is stable. Or if there are 8 electrons into the outermost shell, then also that atom is stable. How it will become stable? Now you only give me answer. Just now I said you, if two electrons, if it would be there, then it would be stable. If 8 electrons into the outermost shell, then also it will be stable. Now, here in case of sodium, we can see that outermost shell contains only one electron. Right? So, is it stable? No. It's highly reactive, students. This is highly reactive. Why it is highly reactive? Because it contains one outermost shell electron and it wants to be stable. Sodium wants to be stable. So for stability, either it has to accept 7 electrons or it has to donate 1 electron. Now students, you only tell me, what will be easier for the sodium atom, to accept 7 electrons and to be stable, or to donate 1 electron and to be stable? I think you are guessing to donate 1 electron. Because to take 7 electrons, it's very difficult for the sodium. It's very difficult. Why it is difficult, that we will learn later. Okay. But it's not easy now. Suppose I have 1 rupee and you have 9 rupee and we want to collect 10 rupee. What will be easier for us? If I will donate you 1 rupee, it will be easier for us to make the 10 rupee note. Right? Or would it be easy to take 9 rupees from you and make 10 rupees for me easier? No. You would say, madam, you give your 1 rupee, we will make 10 rupee note. Right? Likewise here, it would be very easy if it would be donate 1 electron. If it would be donate 1 electron, it will become stable. Okay? So always the metals have capacity to donate their electrons. Right? Metals will have a tendency, capacity means tendency, to donate their 1 electron. Not only 1 electron, however they have. okay, they are always donating electrons and being stable. And see, students, those who are donating something or doing some good work, how they feel? They feel relaxed, they feel positive. So what happens here, when it gives the one electron, then it has 11 positive protons into the nucleus. The number of protons are same into the nucleus. But now the number of electrons are less as compared to the proton. Am I right? The number of electrons are less as compared to the proton. How many electrons are there, student? Now electrons are how many? 10 electrons. How many electrons? 10 electrons. Why 10 electrons? Because one electron has donated. Right? One electron has donated. So now which number? Which sign would be here? If plus 11 proton and minus 10 electron, what will be the sign should be there for this? There should be a positive sign, because then positive signs means protons are more than the number of electrons, right? So it will have what? Positive sign. And how many electrons the sodium has donated? One electron. So it will have sodium plus, because it has donated one electron. It can be written 1 plus, but 1 we never write. If 2 would be there, we have written 2. It is donating one electron, so it would be written as a Na plus. And as it turns as a Na plus, now it is a metal. Before it, whenever it had 11 proton and 11 electron, it was considered to be any element. It was not considered to be metal. When it has donated its one electron, now it is turned out to be a ion, right? It is called as a cation. It is called as what? Cation. Understood? Cation means positively charged ion. Positively charged ion is called as what? Cation. I hope this concept is clear for you. Understood? And in this manner, the metals have tendency to lose electron and to be stable. And because of that, the very one important property of the metal is that metals are always electropositive in nature. This concept was very, very important. And this concept you must understand. For that sake, you may see this video twice, thrice, and then too, if you did not understand, you may please let me know. So this was my today's point, to understand what is mean by metal. What is mean by metal? And through the atomic structure, I have tried to reach you about the structure of the metal. Okay. So metals are always electropositive in nature. Yesterday I said you may say gold is a good metal, rhodium is a very expensive metal, or platinum is an expensive metal. But these are expensive, these are called as a noble metals, because these noble metals are less reactive. They don't have, see the person, we say this person is very noble. Why we say? Because this person is very calm and quiet, never reacting on in any situation, always being very calm. He does not worry about anyone, or he does not have any grudges about anyone in the mind. So that person is what? Noble person, right? So metals are, some metals are also there, like silver, gold and platinum. These metals are also noble metals, because these metals are least reactive. And according to the science, yesterday also I said you, if the metal is very, very less reactive, then that metal is not good metal according to the chemistry. For us, it is precious. But for the chemistry, the metal who is very reactive. So I think sodium is the most reactive. So for the chemistry, it is very fruitful to do various experiments. And as well as it is playing also an important role to know us a chemistry, right? So my today's topic is what? What is metal? And through atomic structure, I explain you metal means what. Thank you so much. And then too, if you have any doubt, please anytime do let me know. Thank you so much, dear students. Have a very wonderful day. Thank you.